Good morning to children. In previous class we completed 11 problems. Now we are going to the 12th problem. See ma, a number is divided into two parts. A number is divided into two parts such that one part is 10 more than the other. One part is 10 more than the other. If the two parts in the ratio, five is to three, find the number and the two parts. Find the number and the two part, but we are given Seema, the ratio is in two parts. The ratio of two parts equal to 5:3. The ratio of two parts equal to 5:3. 5:3. Okay. One part equal 5x. One part equal to 5x. Other part means second part. Other part equal 3x. One part equal to 5x. Other part equal to 3x. We are divided into two parts. Okay. According to the problem. One part equal 10 more than the other. 10 more than the other. One part equal 10 more than the other. One part to 5x. 5x equal 10 more than the other. More than means addition. So 10 plus 3x. Okay. Now 5x minus 3x. Minus 3x means transposing RHS to LHS minus equal to 10. 5x minus 3x, 2x. 2x equal 10. X equal 10 by 2. Here multiplication on left side. Transposing LHS to RHS divided by 2 ones, 2 fives. X equal to 5. X equal to 5. First, one part equal 5x. 5x means 5 into 5. X value 5 came up. That's why 5 into 5. 5 is 25. Other part equal 3x. 3x means 3 into 5. 3 5 is 15. Therefore, the number equal, number means one part plus the other part. The number equal 25 plus 15 equal to 40. Okay, 25 plus 15 equal to 40. Once again, Seema, the ratio of two parts of 5:3. Let one part equal 5x, other part equal 3x. According to the problem, one part equal 10 more than the other. 10 more than the other. 5x equal 10 plus 3x. 5x minus 3x equal to 10. Now 5x minus 3x is 2x. 2x equal to 10. X equal 10 by 2. 2 1 2, 2 5 2. One part means 5x means 5 into 5. 25. Other part to 3x. 3 into 5. 15. The number equal 25 plus 15 equal to 40. Okay, next 13th problem, Seema. Sohna said multiplying my number by 5 and adding 8 to it gives the same answer. Yeah, subtracting my number from 20, find Sohna's number. We don't know Sohna's number, ma. First of all, let Sohna's number equal to x. Solution C. Let Sohna's number equal to x. Multiplying the number by 5 equal to 5x. Multiplying the number by 5 means 5x. Okay, next 5x adding 8. Adding 8. Adding means addition ma. 5x plus 8. Okay, multiplying the number by 5 means 5x. 5x adding 8, 5x plus 8. Next, subtracting the number from 20. Subtracting the number from 20. Subtracting the number from 20 equals 20 minus x. 20 minus x. Now, according to the problem, multiplying the number by 5 and adding to 8 equal to subtracting the number from 20. That's why 5x plus 8 equal 20 minus x. 5x plus 8 equal to 20 minus x. Now 5x minus x transposing RHS to LHS plus x equal to 20 plus 8 transposing LHS to RHS minus 8. 5x plus x, 6x equal to 20 minus 8, 12. 20 minus 8, 12. Now x equal, here left side multiplication, transposing LHS to RHS divided by 12 by 6. 12 by 6. 6 1s, 6 2s. Now x equal to 2. X equal to 2. Therefore, Sohana's number equal to 2. Once again, see ma. Like Sohana's number x, multiplying the number by 5, 5x. 5x adding 8, 5x plus 8. Subtracting the number from 20 equal 20 minus x. According to the problem, 5x plus 8 equal to 20 minus x. 5x plus x equal 20 minus 8. 5x plus x, 6x. 6x equal to 12. Now x equal 12 by 6. 6 1s, 6 2s. X equal to, x means Sohana's number. Sohana's number equal to 2. Okay, next 14th problem. The teacher tells the class that the highest marks obtained by a student in her class is twice the lowest marks plus 7. The highest mark is 87. What is the lowest mark? Here asking, what is the lowest mark? We don't know. That's why let the lowest mark x. Solution. Let the lowest mark equal to x. The highest mark given already, the highest mark 87. Okay. Twice the lowest mark plus 7 equal to lowest mark x mark. Twice means 2x. 2x plus 7. Twice the lowest mark plus 7 equal 2x plus 7. According to the problem, highest mark equal the lowest mark plus 7. The lowest mark plus 7. Okay, highest mark, how much mark? 87. Highest mark equal to twice the lowest mark. 2x plus 7. Twice the lowest mark plus 7. 2x plus 7. Now, 87 plus 7 transposing RHS to LHS minus 7 equal to 2x. 87 minus 7 equal to 2x. 87 minus 7, 80. 80 equal to 2x. Now x equal 80 by 2. 80 by 2. 2 ones are 240. Therefore x equal 40. X equal to 40. 40 means the lowest mark equal to 40. Therefore the lowest mark. The lowest mark equal to 40. Okay, once again see, the lowest mark we don't know. Let the lowest mark x. The highest mark 87 given. That twice the lowest mark plus 7 means 2x plus 7. According to the problem, highest mark equal twice the lowest mark plus 7. Highest mark is 87 given. 87 equal 2x plus 7. Plus 7 transposing RHS to LHS minus 7. 87 minus 7 equal to 2x. 87 minus 7, 80. 80 equal 2x. Now x equal to 80 by 2. 2 ones to 240. X equal to 40. X means therefore the lowest mark equal to 40. In adjacent figure, find the magnitude. In adjacent figure, find the magnitude of each of the three angles formed. Each of the three angles formed. See my here adjacent figure. This is a line. Here three angles formed. X, 2x and 3x. We know that sum of three angles at a point on a line is 180 degrees. We know that sum of angles at a point on a line is 180 degrees. Here three angles given. See, sum of three angles. Sum of three angles at a point on a line is 180 degrees. Sum of three angles at a point on a line is 180 degrees. Here angles given ma x, 2x and 3x. Now sum means addition. X plus 2x plus 3x equal to 180 degrees. X plus 2x plus 3x equal to 180 degrees. X plus 2x, 3x. 3x plus 3x, 6x. 6x equals 180 degrees. 6x equal to 180 degrees. Now x equal 180 by 6. 180 by 6. 6. 3 is 80. Now x equal to 30 degrees. X equal to 30 degrees. The magnitude angles of 3. The 3 magnitude angles are 3 magnitude angles equal to x, 2x and 3x. X means 30 degrees comma 2x means 2 into 30. 3 into 30 equal to 30 degrees comma 2 into 30. 230 is 60. 60 degrees. 330 is 90 degrees. Okay, the three magnitude angles are 30 degrees, 60 degrees and 90 degrees. See my last problem. Solve the following riddle. I am a number. Tell my identity. Take me two times over. And add a 36 to reach a century. You still need four. Okay. Solve the riddle. Mark the solution. Let me x. Taking two times. Two times means 2 into x. Taking 2 times equals 2x. Taking 2 times 2x. Adding a 36. Add means addition plus 36 equal to 2x plus 36. 2x plus 36. To reach a century, you still need 4. Okay, 2x plus 36 equal 100 minus 4. Century. To reach century, you still need 4. That's why 100 minus 4. 2x plus 36 equals 100 minus 4, 96. 2x plus 36 equal to 100 minus 4, 96. Now 2x equal 96 minus 36. 96 minus 36. Now 2x equal 96 minus 36, 60. X equal 60 by 2. X equal to 60 by 2. 2 1s, 2 30s. X equal to 30. Therefore, the required number equal to 30. Okay, once see ma. Let me x. Okay, taking 2 times means 2 into x, 2x. Adding a 36. 2x plus 36. To reach century, you still need 4. Now 2x equal 96 minus 36, 60. X equal 60 by 2, 30. Therefore, the required number equal to 30. Okay, ma, today's enough. This chapter also completed. Thank you.